Welcome, dear students. Welcome, dear students. Come on, join the session very fast. Come on, join the session. Welcome to the GradeUp, the India's largest e-learning platform, dear students. Yes, come on, join the session. Yes, come on, join the session very fast. Yes, dear students, there was some technical issue, because of that we got late. So anyways, let us start the today's session, dear students, which is on welding. Yesterday we have completed the session on casting technology. Shubham, very good evening. Chandrabhan, very good evening. Subramaniam, very good evening, dear. So come on, ask your friends to join the session, share this session, like this session. Yesterday we had the questions on the metal casting, and as per the schedule, dear students, we are having today the welding technology, and we are going to have these questions regarding to the welding technology. So this is short information about me, dear students. I am Omkar, having more than 10 years of experience for teaching GATE and ESE. I have mentored more than 10,000 number of students for GATE and ESE. My area of expertise are production and industrial engineering and the fluid mechanics as well. So dear students, this is one very important information for you, dear students. This is the GradeUp National Scholarship Test, which is on 19th of December. So do register this, right? So you can see here the scholarship pool up to 50 lakhs. That is too much. Please, please register to that test. So this is the brief timetable, okay, buffer timetable is here. You can go through this. There is a syllabus, okay. Syllabus for the test is also here for stage 1 and stage 2. Now this is, we are coming to directly our, coming to the session. Okay, Vignesh, good evening, Vignesh. Good evening. So shall we start? Shall we start? Yes, am I audible and visible to you, dear students? Am I audible and visible to you? So this is the first question on this welding technology, dear students. Welding. So definitely you can get here 2 to 3 marks, of course, in the GATE paper. And out of that, you will be definitely having one of the numerical for 2 marks. And we are trying to cover here that part only, which is very, very important as far as the examination is concerned, right? So shall we begin? Shall we begin? So shall we begin the session? Yes, come on, join the session very fast. Yes, dear students, yes. Are bolo to sahi, bolo. Am I audible and visible? So be active in the chat box, be active in the chat box. Okay, so let us solve this question, dear students. See, the two steel plates are spot welded at the current of, current de diya hai, current is given, I in amperes. So how much it is? Current I, it is 5000 ampere, and the electrodes used are 5 mm in diameter. Electrode diameter is how much? 5 mm, right? So dear, each plate is having thickness of 1 mm. So say these are the plates of thickness 1 mm. This is the resistance spot welding, okay? Then what is there? The current flow time is given, tau is given. How much tau? The current is flowing for 0.2 seconds, okay? Then the heat required to melt the steel is how much? The heat required to melt the steel is given as 10 joules per mm cube. Delta is given. Okay, fine. Resistance is how much? 200 micro ohm. So what they are asking? What they are asking? The heat generated and its distribution in the well. Heat generated and its distribution in the well. So you know very well. So say these are the electrodes, two electrodes. Okay, which are doing this pot welding. Okay, their penetration into this plates, and this is our nugget which is formed. That you know very well. Now tell me how to calculate the heat generated. You know very well. Very famous formula for the resistance welding. Heat generated in the resistance welding, it is given by heat generated is equal to I square R tau. Please be with your calculators. Calculators ready rakhna bhai. So I current kitna flow ho raha hai bhai? 5000 ampere. How much current is flowing through the circuit? 5000 ampere into resistance is how much? Overall total resistance of 200 micro ohm, that is micro, that is 200 into 10 to the power minus 6 ohm. And for how much time current is flowing? Current is flowing for 0.2 seconds. Tell me how much heat generated? 5000 square into 200 into e to the power minus 6 into 0.2. So it is around 1000 joules. This is the heat generated. If you look at the option here, so you can definitely say that. So B is the correct answer. Only one, only that option showing you the generated heat is 1000 joules. But dear students, instead of that, they are saying and its distribution in the weld zone. So weld zone actually, so after the heat which is provided for melting of the joint, so after that rest of the heat is going to get distributed in the particular weld zone. Okay, if this is a weld zone, in weld zone it is getting distributed. So what they are asking, the heat distributed in the weld zone. So how to calculate that? That is the reason why we need to calculate how much heat is actually get supplied into the weld, or heat required to melt the joint. I hope समझ में आ रहा है कि नहीं भाई, आ जाओ सब लोग. So heat required to melt the joint कैसे निकलते हैं? That is volume of nugget, that is your spot, into heat required per unit volume, that is given to you 10 joules per mm cube. So what is the volume of nugget? It is the straight cylindrical nugget, pi by 4 d square into h into this delta. So what is diameter of nugget? They are saying, say it is 5 mm in diameter. Okay, and see, there is a thickness of plate 1 mm each. So if I take thickness as 1 mm plus 1 mm, then total will be how much? 2 mm. So 2 mm is there, but dear students, as you know that there is a penetration of the tip of the electrode into the plate. So if I draw it here, this diagram, so you know that suppose these are the two plates, so there is a penetration, isn't it? So if I consider that this penetration is say 0.25 mm, so from the top it is 0.25 and from the bottom it is 0.25. You can assume like this. So what is the height of the nugget? Tell me. So 2 minus this 0.25 plus 0.25, that is 0.5. It is equally 1.5, which is the height of the nugget, isn't it? Which is nothing but this height of the nugget, isn't it? So tell me, what is the height of the nugget? 1.5. So calculate the heat required to melt the nugget. Pi by 4 into diameter is how much? 5 square into thickness is, or height of the nugget is 1.5 into pi by 4 d square h into how much heat is there required to melt the steel? It is 10 joules per mm cube. It is 10 joules per mm cube. Calculate, put the values. Tell me the value. Yes or no? So how much it is? 25 into 1.5 pi divided by 4 into 10. So it is 294.5. Dear students, please be there and help me for the calculations. Kalpana, what is the value of this heat required to melt the nugget? It is 294.54, dear. It is joules. So actually, how much heat generated? How much heat generated? Heat generated was 1000. And out of that, heat only required for melt the nugget is what? 294.52. So if you subtract this this heat required to melt the nugget from this generated heat, you will get the heat which is distributed to the rest or weld zone, which is how much? 1000 minus 294.52. It is 705.47 joules. So dear student, this is the heat distributed in the weld zone. Now check the option and tell me the answer. So yes, 1000 joule and 705 joule. B Bombay is the correct answer. Aman, very good evening dear. B Bombay is the correct answer. Yes, Kalpana correct. Aman is correct. Sri Kumar is correct. Come on dear student, join the session. Like this only we are going to solve a very nice numericals from each and every topic in the production engineering. Do join this session, like this session, share this session. Yes, next question. Shall I go for the next? Take the next question. This is in front of you. Good evening, Amandeep. So, dear students, see the voltage length characteristic is given. V arc, voltage in the arc is given as 10 plus 30 L. Okay, from this is a characteristic voltage in the arc, and from the power source it is how much? Voltage is equal to 60 minus 0.007 times I. Okay, and what they are saying, the optimum arc length is how much? So dear students, when we need to calculate the optimum arc length, you know the condition. See, I am going ahead into the solutions by considering that at least you should have the basic conceptual things or basic concept of each and every topic. Based on that only I am moving ahead. Please remember that. Don't forget this thing. And I am hoping that you are knowing these things and then I am going ahead. Now you know that there will be the optimum arc length which can be based on when you can calculate the power, okay, which is equal to V into I. And when you take the product of that voltage and current and differentiate with respect to L, you will definitely get the arc length. So for that reason, we need the voltage in terms of L and also the current in terms of L. Okay, and for the optimum condition, the voltage from the arc and voltage which is given from the power source, it should be same. So voltage from the arc and voltage from the power source, it should be same. So what is voltage in the arc? So dear, tell me, what is voltage in the arc? What is voltage in the arc? That is 10 plus 30 L should be equal to voltage from the power source, 60 minus 0.07 times I. So these two should be the same, isn't it? Now tell me, see, you are having the voltage, okay, in terms of L, that is 10 plus 30 L. Only the thing is that you should require this current in terms of L. So just simplify the things. So what it can be? So it will be 0.07 I is equal to 60 minus 10 minus 30 L. Isn't it? Just simplification. Yes or no? Tell me the values. So this 0.07 I can be, it will be 60, that is already this is 60 minus 10, 50 minus 30 L. 50 minus 30 L, please check. Yes or no? Tell me the value. Now, what is I? What can be written for the I? So, I will be 50 minus 30 L divided by this 0.07. Tell me what is the final thing I can get here. Please comment in the chat box. Yes. So what I will be getting? So I will get the I, that is I in terms of L, what I will get? That is say 50 divided by the 0.07 minus 30 L divided by the 0.07, isn't it? So what I will get? I is equal to what I will get? So please check 714.28. So this is solved by me. I am writing the values directly. Please check. Minus 428.57 L. Please check it out whether you have got I in terms of L like this. Yes, Shivam, Vignesh, Amandeep, Kalpana, please check whether you are getting this I in terms of L like this. So be ready with the calculators, sit for solving the questions, not only just attending the or seeing the sessions, okay? So if you get this value, voltage already in terms of L is available and now current, so I am giving you the sufficient time, okay? So this is actually done by me, I am writing here, please check whether am I right or wrong, okay? If you are getting the same, shall I move ahead? Very good, Aman, very good. Now see, so this is the current and voltage already there. Now you can write power is equal to what? It is a product of voltage into current. So voltage is how much? Voltage is 10 plus 30 L into current. Just now you have calculated in terms of L, 714.28. Minus 428.57 L. Okay, now very nicely solve these two brackets. Kajal, very good Kajal. Viravel, very good. Kalpana, very good. Sri Kumar, very good. Very nice. Come on, participate, dear student. Unless you participate by taking the pen and calculators in your hands, maza nahi aayega bhai, maza nahi aayega. So be in the lecture. Yes, so tell me what is this product and what is this product. So if I have the product, so I will get some value around say 8570 minus 1428 minus 4284L plus 25710L minus 4284L minus 12852L square. Okay. And dear student, if I want the optimum arc length, what should I do? I should differentiate this power with respect to L and equate it with respect to 0. So please check it out. When you are trying to find out the optimum arc length, we have to differentiate the power with respect to the arc length and equate to 0, you will get the L optimum. Now differentiate this. So what is dp by dl here? Dp by dl will be how much? So this will be constant 0, this will be 0. So okay, now tell me whether it is correctly written. So if you differentiate this, dear students, so I will get here, see, that is 17 17142 is equal to 25704L something. Just Kajal, what happened? Yes, Subramanyam, very good. Subramanyam, very nice. So if you just solve it very nicely, now this is simple algebra, 10th level algebra, you can do it and take the differentiation, not a very big deal. So finally, if you calculate by taking the differentiation and equating to the zero, you will get the optimum arc length as, how much? So I am getting here L optimum here, it is 0.67 centimeter. Please check it out. Only by just seeing the session, nothing is going to happen. You just take the calculators, the apply your fingers there and tell me the value. So if you calculate very nicely, I am saying very nicely and calmly, you have to get this value 0.67. Check it out, 0.67. So Amir Khan, so how much you are getting, please tell me very fast. Yes, tell me the value. Okay, yes, so after getting the 0.67 as optimum arc length, now just calculate the optimum bar. What they are asking in the question, what they are asking, the optimum, what will be the arc power corresponding to the optimum arc length. Now it is very easy to calculate the power. So you know that power is equal to what? V into I, where it is voltage is 10 plus 30 L already calculated. Okay. And we already know 714.28 minus 428.57 into L optimum. You just put the value of L optimum 0.67. You will get the power. Tell me what will be the power. Yes, Subramanyam, what will be the power you are getting here? So you will be getting 12856.8 watts. Okay, how much you are going to get, please check it out whether you are getting this 12800560, that is 12.856 kilowatt. Please check it out. Aman, Kalpana, Subramanyam, Sri Kumar, whether are you getting the same? Whether are you getting the same or not? Please check it out. 12856. Okay, Sri Kumar, Kajal. Very good. So I hope it is okay. Very good. Come on. One, two, eight, five, seven. That is the absolutely correct answer. I hope you get the answer. So the thing is that the basics are very clear. Whenever we need to calculate the optimum arc length, there should be the availability of the arc voltage in terms of the arc length, and there should be the availability of the current equation in terms of the arc length. Once you have that, you just take the product of voltage and current and then differentiate with respect to L, you will get the optimum arc length, and put that length into again into the same power equation, that is V into I, you will get the required power. Amandeep, very good. Subramanyam, very good. Sri Kumar, Kalpana, very good. Nice. Next question. We'll go ahead for the next question. Tell me, We will solve this question, dear students. We will solve this question. So voltage in the arc is given by which formula or the equation? Voltage in the arc is given as 25 plus 5 L. Okay, that is given. And the power source characteristics is approximated as I square is equal to minus 350 into bracket V minus 90. Isn't it? Now here they have given the arc length which is changing from 4 millimeter to 6 millimeter. Arc length changing from 4 millimeter to 6 millimeter. Suppose arc length L1 is 4 millimeter and it is changing to L2 as 6 millimeter. Now what they are asking? The change in the welding current is how much? Change in the welding current is how much? So beta, just go ahead. The voltage in the arc is known to you. So calculate V1 will be how much? For length L1, so when L1 is there, what is V1? So it is 25 plus 5 into L is how much? 4. L1 is 4. So tell me what is there. So 25 plus 20, it will be 45 volts. And what is V2? That is 25 plus 5 into L2 is how much? 6 millimeter. So it is 25 plus 30, it will be 55 volts. Now dear students, you know very well, you know very well what you know. As dear students, you know that arc length increases, it is linearly proportional to the voltage, voltage also increases. But dear students, when arc length increases, so there will be the increase in resistance, go to the infinity. So definitely current, when the arc length is increases, there will be the decrease in current. And when arc length is decreases, the gap between this electrode and the workpiece is decreases, that is voltage also decreases. Now the gap is less, the resistance is less, so definitely current going to be high. So you know that relation, Now tell me, means what? Simple way mein yaad rakhna dear students, this arc length is inversely proportional to the current. Okay, whenever there is a minimum arc length, there is a maximum current. And whenever there is a maximum arc length, there will be the minimum current. Voltage behaves in a linear manner, directly proportional. Okay, now tell me, now if I want to write I1, so I1 is what? The equation of the current minus 350, that is I1 square, it is minus 350 into bracket V minus 90. So it will be V for I1 minimum, voltage should be maximum, that is arc length should be maximum. So it will be 350 into bracket 55 minus, tell me 55 minus 90. How much it is? Minus 350 into 55 minus 90. That is 90 minus 55. It is minus 35. And what is minus 35 into 350? Into minus 350. It will be 12,250. So tell me what is I1. Take the square root. I1 will be root of this. You get it as 110.67 amperes. Okay, and what is I2 square? It will be minus 350 into bracket V minus 90. So that is V1, because I2, when it is maximum, when the arc length is minimum, and arc length and voltage are directly proportional. So that is the reason why I am taking V1 there. Isn't it? Okay, now see, if I write here minus 350 into what is V1? V1 I calculated as 45 minus 90, that is minus 45. So 45 into 350 and root over answer, it will be, I directly am writing 125.49 ampere. Very good. So this is I2 and this is I1. What they are asking? Yes, Gaikwad. Yes, Gaikwad. Why not? These are the questions for the gate only. Okay. See, in the gate examinations, you will find very lengthy questions also. Okay. So definitely if you try to have practice for these questions, definitely it will be benefited to you. Yes, only yes, Sri Kumar, that is correct. Praveen, see, there is your answer in the chat box. Sri Kumar, what is he saying? You have to practice such a questions too. Now, what is delta? What is change in current? I delta I will be I2 minus I1. How much it is? 125.49 minus 110.67. How much it is? Okay, Praveen, thank you so much. And do attend the sessions here also. 110.67. So it is 14.82 ampere. This is the change in current. Kalpana, have you got this answer? 14 point, very nice, very nice. Amandeep, very good. Kalpana, very good. Shri Kumar, very nice. Fine, very good, very good. So 14.82 is the correct answer. Next, next. Take this question. See, if you solve such a kind of question on the welding, so there is no any other thing left, okay, which can be very lengthy or critical. So the questions on arc welding, questions on resistance spot welding, that will be the gray area for asking the numericals as far as the gate is concerned. Isn't it? So just do this. For a DC arc, the voltage arc length characteristic is given by voltage in the arc is given by 18 plus 25 L. Okay, the operating voltage is VO, open circuit voltage or operating voltage. Okay, sorry, it is a arc voltage. And see, the power source characteristics can be approximated by straight line. With the open circuit voltage, VO is given 75 volts, and the short circuit current IS is the short circuit current is given as 800 ampere. Okay. Then what they are saying, what will be the optimum arc length? What will be the optimum arc length? So dear students, how to calculate this? How to calculate this? You know very standard formula. Okay, I am not going to derive it here, but we can very easy. So we can write here V arc by V naught plus I in the arc by I from the supplier, that is from the transformer, is equal to 1. Okay, so what is V arc here? It is given 18 plus 25L divided by VO is how much? 75 plus I is how much? Nothing is given. I, we have to write in terms of L. It is from the arc. And what is short circuit current? It is 800 ampere. It is equal to 1. Now, to calculate the optimum arc length, we, jaisa maine already bola tha, we need to write the voltage in terms of L. It is already given. Now, the thing is that current in terms of L. So, definitely we will do that. So, what I can write? So, I divided by 800 is equal to 1 minus this 18 plus 25 L, okay, divided by 75. Isn't it? And just multiply by 800 here. So I will be equal to, say, 800 minus, so 800 divided by 75, 10.67 into bracket 18 plus 25 L. Now simplify this. So multiply by this 10.67 into bracket. So 800 minus this into 18. I am getting here 192 minus 192. Okay. Minus 10.67 into 25. 10.67 into 25. I'm getting 266.75 minus 266.75 times this L times this L. So please, please tell me, tell me. Kharse, very, very, very welcome to the grade up. So what is 800 minus 192? Kharse, you are very fast. It is 608 minus 266.75 times L. Please, please tell me whether I am doing correct or wrong. Whether, yes, Akhilesh, you are absolutely correct. You are absolutely correct here. Just tell me whether you have got the same equation for the current. Please check it out. Okay. Now voltage is what? 18 plus 25 L, right? And if you now have the power is equal to what? Voltage into current. So voltage is 18 plus 25 L into bracket current is what? 608 minus 266.75 L. Solve this product very nicely. And you will be getting, I hope you should get around, say this is equal to minus 6666.75 L square plus 10399.94 L plus 10944. Please check it out. Priyanka, please check it out. And now what is the thing we have to do? You just differentiate this power dp by dl. Differentiate power with respect to L. Kalpana, very good Kalpana, 0.7 it is the correct answer. Akhilesh is correct, Kalpana is correct. So if I differentiate this, after differentiating I will be getting minus 666, it is 4 times 6, 0.75 into 2L plus 10399.94 and equate to 0. And very nicely, if you solve this, you will be getting L is equal to 0.78 centimeter. Very nicely, you will get 0.78 centimeter. Absolutely correct. Very nice. Very nice. Very nice. Very nice. Come on, join the session, dear students. Every day, every day. Amandeep, very good. Very good, Amandeep. So, every day, this crash course is going to, yes, run for... not only production, again it will get continued. So please do join the sessions, dear students. Vignesh, very good. Vignesh, very nice, dear. Priyanka, have you got 0.78? So I hope now if you look at the options, yes, 0.78, this is the option A is very correct. Option A is correct. Option A is very correct. Yes, Aman, very good, Aman. I hope it is clear. Now see, this is related to the arc welding, and here again in arc welding, We know that. So the power input is directly from the electric current, isn't it? So there is the heat input. Okay, the net heat input, we generally know that the heat input is given in terms of what? Or rather heat input rate, even if I say that is no any big deal. So it will be equal to the power divided by velocity. It is will be in joule per mm, it will be joule per centimeter, it will be in joule per millimeter. So that will be the power divided by V is what? The velocity or speed of welding. Velocity or this is the speed of welding in case of the arc welding. And definitely if there are some losses of the heat, okay, some losses are there. So definitely there will be the heat transfer efficiency is given. Heat transfer efficiency is there. You can have eta HT if it is there. So you can directly write that heat input rate or heat input you can write as equal to power is what? the voltage into current. Okay, and if you have some losses of heat, definitely you can multiply by the heat eta HT, that is heat transfer efficiency, divided by the speed of welding B. So this is the heat input we can write in case of the arc weld. Okay, and dear students, now someone if asking you to calculate the melting efficiency. Okay, so melting efficiency, there is one more thing, melting efficiency. So how to get that melting efficiency, dear students, which is represented by says eta M. So it is equal to what? Heat required to melt the joint. Heat required to melt the joint divided by the heat supplied. Heat supplied. So the thing is that here, dear students, we need to understand how much heat is required to melt the joint. So for that, suppose say with the example, we try to understand how we can get. Suppose there are the two plates. Suppose the plate thickness is say 5 millimeter. Okay, and this gap between the in the butt weld, if we are going to join them, say the plates having the distance between them, or they are say 4 centimeter or 4 millimeter apart. 4 millimeter apart. And you started this making the weld with the electrode travel speed V. Okay, then dear student, definitely. And suppose the heat required to melt that material is given in terms of say joule per mm cube. Okay, that is heat given. Now in that case, dear students, we can have the heat required to melt the joint, that particular this joint, it will be nothing but what? The volume of the weld into volume of the weld, volume of the weld into the heat required per unit volume. Heat required per unit volume. So what is volume? You know, this is area, area A, which is in 5 into 4, 5 by 4, that is 20 millimeter square. This is area into, to calculate the volume, which is running volume with the travel speed if I write, or volume flow rate if I take in terms of this velocity, because velocity is meter per second. So in that case, or millimeter per second, in case of the welding, it is very slow, slow speed. So I will take it in millimeter per second. So this area into velocity into this delta, it is my heat required to melt the joint. Okay. Now I get heat required to melt the joint, area into velocity into delta divided by, I am talking about melting efficiency. So it is how much divided by heat supplied is how much from the main switch. Okay. Power V into I. And if there are some losses, so there will be the, if heat transfer efficiency given, it is multiplied to this power. So in this way, dear students, we get the formula for the melting efficiency. Melting efficiency is equal to area of the weld into velocity of that weld, or the speed of the welding into delta divided by eta HT into this power V into. Based on that, we will solve some questions. Let us start. This is already solved. This is already solved. I hope you can solve this question. This is from GATE 2007. Very nice question again from the same theme, that is V by V naught plus I by IS is equal to 1. Okay, so here generally we are from arc, we are voltage arc equation, we are going to find out some different things, but here in this question we have to go in reverse manner to find out the equation of this voltage in the arc. They are asking like this. So just go and solve this question. Very nice question. You definitely get this answer, as I hope A is the answer. Not a very big deal. Now just tell me the solution for this. This is also we solve the questions on the resistance welding. Take it as a homework. Okay, no any big deal. Very easy question. Okay, today we got some technical issue. That's why I got late. After 8 there will be some another faculty who is conducting the late sessions. So we are having a lot of questions actually. Okay, for this, so because what you see, resistance welding, arc welding is that part is done, and you can solve that question based on the whatever the understanding from the previous question. No any big deal. Now just tell me, solve this question. In arc welding process, the voltage and the current are, voltage is how much? Simple, 25 volts. And current is how much? 300 ampere. Okay, arc, see, heat transfer efficiency eta HT is given. Eta xt is given. How much it is? 25 volts, current is 300 amperes, then eta xt is how much? It is 85%. Okay, welding speed is given 8 mm per second. Okay, what they are asking? The net heat input. They are asking the net heat input. Okay, Pratik Sharma, it is, so you just do it by your own. Do it by your own by seeing it two times, and again without seeing anything, just do it for two, three times. More than enough, more than enough. So whatever the questions that we have here in this PPT, definitely I am going to provide you this PDF of this PPT. Just solve this question, more than enough. Akhilesh, you know, previous year. So tell me, so actually theme, I hope the concept is very important. Based on this, many questions they are asking the theoretical question also. Okay, based on this equation, what is the equation? That is this heat input H is equal to this eta HT into VI divided by small v. Yes or no? So what is eta HT? 0.85. What is voltage? 25. What is current? 300 divided by what is speed of welding? 8. Yes, come on dear students, tell me the answer. What is heat input in joules per millimeter? It is 796.875 joule per millimeter. Per millimeter, please remember, because divided by velocity is there. Okay. Yes, Akhilesh, that is so simple. And this is again, see, this is IIT Kharagpur question, 2006. Okay, 2006. Yes, Kalpana, very nice. Kalpana, very nice. 796.87. Very good. Excellent. So, ask your friends to join this session, dear students. These are very helpful sessions. For theoretical production question, dear Pratik, you need to read. Okay, and this is not time actually. This is not, if you are appearing for GATE 2021, so this is not the time to read. This is the time to solve, to practice. Okay, because see, more than 70-80% of the paper is, the theme is of course clear to you. These are the numerical based. Okay, so you need to solve. Right now, no need to fear about this, because अभी ये time ही नहीं है प्रतीक. So don't think about it. जो हाथ में है वो करो. So at this moment, formulas and how to apply that formulas, what are the conditions for applying those formulas, that is also important. Only for knowing the formula is not necessary. How to apply in various situations, that is a very important thing. Okay, and it is very important for certain formulas. So as far as say thermodynamics formulas are concerned, so situational formulas, for that definitely your previous study should be more than enough for that. I hope, nice question. Take the question. Yes. Take the question. Pratik, just you come here and enjoy this session by just practicing these numericals, right? Definitely you will be getting the marks, don't worry. And please remove your fear. Okay, if you want MSQs also, then I'm okay with the MSQs also, right? I'm having the MSQs also, but I'm trying to have the numerical session. Definitely there will be one more series. See dear students, will be available on the YouTube now. So definitely until your examination is going to get over, we will be here only. So we are trying to provide you something at every moment. We are trying to give you something, don't worry about that. Definitely after this I will try to have the MSQs also. So what is the answer? So in arc welding, see butt joint is there. So butt joint like this, same way. Okay. Highest cooling rate is actually melting efficiency is given. Eta M is given. How much? It is 0.5. And heat transfer efficiency is given is 0.7. The area of the cross section of the CC, area of the cross section is given, that is 5 mm². Okay, 5 mm², 5 mm². And the heat required to melt the metal, delta is equal to 10 joules per mm³. And what they are saying, the power directly given, it is 2000 watt directly given. Okay, the welding speed they are asking. Welding speed, very easy, very easy. Okay, so welding speed, how to calculate? Eta M is equal to, what is the formula? Area of that weld, cross section area of the weld, into velocity, which will be representing you length, into delta divided by eta HT times VI. Okay, they are asking this velocity. So it will be eta M into eta HT into VI divided by A into delta. What is eta M? 0.5. What is eta HT? 0.7. What is VI? 2000 divided by area is what? 5. And delta is how much? It is 10. So very nicely, if you calculate, you will get the velocity here, not eta. You will be getting the velocity. Tell me how much velocity. It is 14. Okay, it is 14. See, I am trusting you. I don't know the answer. It is 14. mm/s. Very nice. Excellent, dear students. Excellent. So like this, if you just interact with me, okay, just not only seeing the sessions, apply your fingers, apply your brain, do the calculations and interact with me, this will be the fabulous session, right? So be there tomorrow also, dear students. Tomorrow we'll be having the metal forming. I have two sessions. One is just for the bulk deformation and one session like for the sheet metal operations. We'll be solving the questions once again. Subramanyam, very good. Amandeep, very nice. And I hope Akhilesh is there. Akhilesh Kharse. Very nice, dear students. So see, this is the schedule. So this is the schedule. Please look at the schedule. Casting, yesterday just we have completed. Welding, just now we have discussed about the welding. Tomorrow metal forming and sheet metal working. Out of that metal forming, bulk deformation will be covering tomorrow on 16th of December. Like that, we will go ahead. Yes, time is 7 p.m. Sham ko 7 baje. Every day. Until 21st of December, I will be here only, dear. So see, there will be the metal cutting session 1, session 2, non-traditional machinings, and then advanced machining methods, CIMS also we are going to discuss, same metrology and inspection also. Okay, so be there, like the session, share the session, and do follow me on the GradUp app. Okay, so on the GradUp app also, I am going to do something like this. Right now, I am dealing with the coordinate measuring machine, which is newly added topic. We are having the series on that on the app. After that, again, I will be having the, again, practice sessions for production engineering. So, dear students, thank you so much for joining the session. Be there once again tomorrow and every day till 21st of December. And after that also, some another faculty will come and lead this course, crash course, definitely for you people only. From one and only GradUp. Thank you so much. Material science also completed. But I will plan for that. See, if the subject is theoretical one, people are not interested to attend. Okay, that is the thing why. This is for YouTube only, Kalpana. On app, there are many free sessions are going on. You just visit the app. You will be seeing. Every day there are 5-6 free sessions are there. Okay, like Dheeraj sir is there, Vikas sir is there, Suraj sir is there. So many faculties, very top class faculties are there who are guiding you. Okay, so chalo kal milte fir once again. at 7 p.m. with the metal forming. Right? Be there. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care. Good night. Jai Hind. I hope Dheeraj sir will be live at 8 p.m.